short sequence today looking at some gentle yoga moves that we can use to help recover from diastasis of recti, so the splitting of those abdominal muscles. As always, but then particularly with this sequence, do please make sure you've got clearance from a doctor and that you are obviously able to go ahead and start exercising and start your road to recovery. Obviously, the last thing you want to do is cause any further damage and prolong that recovery time. As we move through, if you feel any kind of pain, I want you to stop immediately. It might just be that that particular move isn't right for you at the moment, and maybe in time, once you've built a little strength back, you might be able to do it then. Or it might just be that that move, that posture, just isn't going to work for you, which is completely fine. It's all about listening to the body, tuning in with what works and what doesn't for us and our bodies. As always, I want you to take it really nice and slowly, particularly with this routine, particularly if you are recovering from diastasis recti. Like I said, the last thing you want to do is cause more damage. So by all means, take it nice and slow. Pause the video at any point. You can always just do one or two moves. Listen to what's working, what isn't. Each of the postures I go through are going to get slightly more intense, I guess, for the abdominal muscles. So again, notice that. So it might just be for now, you can only do maybe the first one or first two or three postures comfortably. And then maybe in a few weeks, a few months, you can start adding in a couple of the others. But just see how you go and hopefully it helps. So the first thing we're going to do is lie down on our backs. So as always, if you don't already do this, don't just go to lie down straight from sitting up. I want you to gently lower yourself onto your side and then roll yourself onto your back. So get nice and comfy here. So see how the lower back feels. See if you wanted, you could have your legs out flat. Or you could bend the knees up, place the feet flat on the floor, just help support the lower back when we're lying down. First thing we're going to do then, just gently placing the hands on the belly. Just do a couple of nice deep breaths. We'll come and give our core contractions a go. So we're going to bring the attention to our belly button. On our next inhale, I want you to think about pulling that belly button in towards the spine. So don't use the breath, don't be sucking in the tummy. All we're trying to do is gently activate these muscles, pulling that belly button in just as much as feels comfy. Hold it for as long as feels doable and comfortable. Keep breathing and gently release. Have a breath or two, and if it feels comfortable to do so, you can gently repeat. So just consciously pulling that belly button in, feeling those muscles starting to turn on, starting to activate. And just repeat this as many times as feels comfortable for you. So this might be a lovely one that you could try a couple of times, maybe first thing in the morning before you get out of bed, or last thing at night. It's also a lovely one because you are tuning into your breath, doing it just before going to bed, like just before going to sleep. It might just help you just gently calm the body down, relax the mind and get you ready for your night's sleep. So we'll repeat that as many times as feels comfortable. So you might want to pause the recording here and carry on. If we want to go a little bit further, we're going to gently come to sit up. So again, we're rolling onto our side first and then using those arms, gently pushing yourself up to a comfy seated position. So if you can, sit with your legs crossed. If that doesn't work, that's uncomfortable for the knees, you can bend the knees, place the feet flat on the floor. If that still doesn't work, just take the legs out ahead of you. So wherever those legs are, tuning into those bony bits of the bum then. So maybe readjusting the seat, pulling the fleshy bits of the bum away, and just really pinning the bum down nice and firm into the mat and the ground beneath you. Imagining our golden thread though, so it's running all the way through our spine, through our neck, and it's just coming out the very tops of our heads. We're gently going to take hold of that thread and just pull it away from the head. So just lengthening through the spine, sitting nice and tall. So creating loads of space in the spine and the abdomen. Hands can rest gently on the knees. Again, we'll take a couple of breaths here. When you're ready then, we're bringing that attention back to that belly button. So we're gently going to be pulling the belly button in towards the spine like we did when we were lying down. So again, we're not sucking in the belly. We're not using the breath to put it in. We're literally just trying to activate these muscles. Just trying to remind them what they're meant to be doing, I guess. So gently pulling that belly button in. Keep breathing. Just hold it for as long as feels comfortable. Gently releasing. Having a couple of breaths. And if you feel like you can repeat it, you can do it another couple of times. So again, just bringing that focus back to the belly button. Pulling it in towards the spine. Keeping hold of that breath. So again, you might want to pause the recording here and just carry on with practicing that one. That's obviously a lovely one you could do seated at your desk. No one would know you were doing it. It's just a really lovely one. Again, you might find it quite calming because you're bringing your attention back to your breath, you're slowing everything down. You're also, hopefully, just starting to activate those tummy muscles and just help them start knitting back together. Again, just repeat it as many times as feels comfy, and I'm probably doing it a couple of times during the day, just here and there, would probably be really beneficial rather than trying to do 10 or 15 or 20 or whatever number comes into your head, like all these repetitions once or twice a day. Maybe doing it a little and often is probably going to have a really good beneficial effect for you. So from there then, so if we want to go a little bit further, if we feel really comfortable then doing those core contractions lying down and doing them seated, we're going to come to lie down on the mats again. So again, lowering ourselves onto our sides nice and gently, rolling onto our back. So once again, the knees are bent, feet flat on the floor. We're going to come and do some toe taps. So we're going to take our hands, we're just gently going to rest them on the hips. So what we want to do as we move through these moves now is really keep those hips and the bum pinned down nice and firm to the mat. So we don't want to be lifting the bum at any point. From here then, coming back to that breath. We're pulling that belly button in like we did at the beginning. So gently pulling it in, gently turning on these abdominal muscles. On our next inhale, we're going to start to bring the right knee towards the chest. We're gently going to take those right toes, we're just going to tap them to the left knee. So if it feels comfortable, we can hold it here. Taking those nice deep breaths, pulling that belly button into the spine. Hold it here for as long as feels comfortable if you can, maybe 3, 4, 5 breaths. You can build it up over time. When you're ready to release then, on the exhale, gently taking that toe away from the knee, lowering that leg down with control, resting that foot there then. Take a couple of breaths here. We're going to come and do the same on the other side. So checking in with that belly button again, pulling it in nice and firm to the spine. Hands are gently resting on those hips as we inhale then. Lifting that left knee towards the chest. Toes are coming to the right knee. Holding it here. Remember, if you're feeling any kind of pain or discomfort, just gently release that foot back down to the mat. And just stick with the first couple of postures if they were what was working for you for now. So holding as long as feels comfy here. When you're ready to release, on the exhale, gently taking those toes away, with control, lowering that foot back down to the mat. Having a breath or two here. So you can repeat that as many times as feels comfortable. Again, just listen to the body, just check in with how it's all feeling. If you're noticing any excessive doming or coning of the tummy muscles, just stop. Just stick with the first couple of postures if they were working for you, and we can build that strength up over time. From here then, we're going to take the legs out flat. We'll have a breath or two here. I want you to think about the lower back now, so really pinning it down as much as we can into the mat below us. So pulling that belly button in towards the spine, feeling those tummy muscles activating as we do so. If it feels okay, you can put a gentle point in the toes. Hands can come down either side, so palms down to the mat. As you inhale, we're just gently going to lift the right foot and leg. So just lifting it a couple of inches and holding it there. So if we're noticing any pain, just gently lower the leg down. Hold it for a couple of breaths if you can. On the exhale, gently lowering it down. Have a breath or two here. So keeping that lower back pinned down as much as we can. Gentle pointing those toes. On the inhale, then we're lifting the left leg this time. So just a couple of inches, just as high as feels comfy. Pinning that belly button in nice and firm to the spine. Holding here for a couple of breaths, or as long as feels comfortable. When you're ready to release, on the exhale, gently lowering that leg back down. So repeat firm alternate legs as much as feels comfortable for you. Try not to do too many of these too quickly. So this might be something that you build up to over time. Again, as always, just listen to the body and do what feels comfortable for you. So if the leg raises felt comfortable, we can give bridge a go. So we're going to bend those knees up, place those feet flat on the floor. We're going to try and bring the heels as close to the bum as we can. So we should just be able to tickle the backs of the heels with our fingertips. Arms are down either side of the body, palms down into the mat. Gaze is going to be up at the ceiling, so we don't want to strain the neck in this. Have a couple of breaths. Pin that belly button into the spine. When you're ready then, on the inhale, we're gently going to lift through the bum and the pelvis. So just lift as far as feels comfy. So to start with, it might just be a couple of inches. You might find you can really lift up nice and high, starting to come up onto the shoulders. Feel the bum and the pelvis come up into line with the knees. So just hold it here as far, as long as feels comfortable. Think about those knees just gently pulling in towards each other. You might be tempted to let them splay outwards, just gently pulling them in, activating through the glutes and the thighs. When you're ready to release, nice and gently on the exhale, really roll down that spine nice and slowly. Your bum and your pelvis is the very last thing to come back down to the mat. So relax here. You can take the legs out straight if that feels comfy. Have a breath or two. When you're ready then, we can go again. So bringing those knees back up, feet flat on the floor, just tickling the backs of those heels. On the inhale then, lifting up through the bum of the pelvis. Just go as high as feels comfy. And if you feel like you could do pulses, like this feels comfortable, gently lower the bum back down after a breath or two. Have a full breath here. And then lift again. Couple of breaths here. Exhale, gently lowering back down. And you can repeat that as often, as many times as feels comfy. So just see how you go. So inhaling to lift. Exhaling to lower. Once you've done a few repetitions of those, just take your legs out straight. Take some lovely deep breaths, so really releasing the abdominal muscles. And once you're ready, if you want to go further still, we're going to come to stand up. So we'll bring the knees in close, gently rolling onto our side, pushing ourselves up from here. So we'll come to stand. You're going to need a wall for this one, or for the next two, man. So to start with, we're just going to place our hands on the wall at shoulder height. Feet are going to be as far away from the wall as is comfy for the arms. So we're going to try and stack the ankles, knees, hips and shoulders. So we're all in one straight line. So we'll gaze at the wall. From here then, all I want you to do to start with is pull that belly button in towards the spine. Nice deep breaths. So whilst with diastasis recti, we want to avoid the traditional plank on the floor. We can start to give this a go if we feel comfortable with the previous moves. So this is effectively a plank but with a wall assist. So activating those muscles then. So see how you go. You might just want to stand here, pulling the belly button in for a few breaths and then releasing, repeating as many times as feels comfortable. If you're feeling comfy here then, we can come and give a plank with a wall assist to go. So from here then, we're going to take a short step back. So probably about foot distance from where we were. So we've just got a little bit of a slant in the bottom. Pulling that belly button in towards the chest. So if we're still feeling okay here, we'll come and give our plank with wall assist a go. So first thing we're going to think about is those elbows. As we lower ourselves down, we're going to keep them nice and close to the body. So what we don't want to be seeing is elbows splaying out to the sides. As we lower ourselves, I want you to imagine those, they're staying really nice and close to the ribs. So we're not seeing this, we're seeing more of this. Once you're ready then, we're pulling that belly button in towards the spine. We'll have a lovely big inhale. As we exhale, really nice and slowly, with control, gently lowering the chest towards the wall. Keeping those elbows nice and tight. Gently pushing back up. So you can do this as many times as feels comfortable. As always, any pain at all, we're going to stop immediately. You might find over time that you can lower yourself towards the wall and maybe hold it here for a couple of breaths. So really thinking about putting that belly button in. And then gently pushing back away. there you go. Those postures I've just shown you are very much, they very much build up on top of the one before. So start with the easy ones, see how you get on, work your way up. This journey of recovery is very much a journey. It's not an instant fix. It's not, you're not going to wake up tomorrow and it's all going to be back to normal. It is going to take time. It is going to take practice and a little bit of determination. But you can and will get there. So just work with the body, listen to the body. Don't push yourself, don't force anything that doesn't feel comfortable or doesn't feel right. So I really hope this helps, and good luck to you.